Hello friends, welcome to GYS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the daily MCQ series of environment and ecology, and we are on the lecture number 22 of this series. Already we have covered 21 lectures, and if you want to see those previous lecture, you can go into the playlist of my channel and can see previous lectures. Friends, we have started this initiative 21 days back, and we will continue this till 31st May. That is one day before when your prelims is scheduled. Your prelims is on 2nd June 2019, and we will end this series on 31st May. So friends, in a way, you will be covering nearly 1100 to 1200 questions of environment and ecology only, as we cover 5 questions daily. So friends, it is not the case that we will cover only environment and ecology. We will cover other topics as well. Actually, we are a little bit busy these days. So from December onwards, the other series, the series of other topics will also be started. For example, history, polity, geography, economy, current affair, and all other topics will also be started. So friends, let's start today's discussion, today's MCQs. So the first question is about the International Solar Alliance. Is an alliance of many countries, most of them being sunshine countries. So what does sunshine country mean? So friends, you might have heard about International Solar Alliance. It is an alliance basically led by India. So the countries that are part of that are called sunshine countries are party to it. So we have to know what is the meaning of sunshine country. So the A option is countries which come either completely or partly between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. Second option is countries that are directly located between Tropic of Capricorn and the equator. C option is countries that are directly located between Tropic of Cancer and the equator. And D option is none of the above. So friends, it is very easy question. Most of the students might know about it. If you don't know, then don't worry. I will let you know. The A option is correct in this question. So the countries that, for example, this is your Earth. So this is equator. This is 23.5 degrees north and 23.5 degrees south. So this is Tropic of Cancer and this is Tropic of Capricorn. So the countries that lie partly or wholly between this Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn are called sunshine countries. So it is an alliance of many countries, most of them being sunshine countries. So more than 120 countries are geographically located in tropics between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, either fully or partially. So they get ample amount of sunlight throughout the year. So the solar energy is easily available there. So basically the need is to tap that energy. So countries also happens to be ones where the maximum growth in energy demand is taking place in coming years, but their current production of energy is lower than their expected requirement. So the ISA will try, but the International Solar Alliance tries to do it. It tries to meet that gap through a renewable source of energy. So will ensure that as these countries rapidly ramp up their electricity production prominently by using clean energy and avoid fossil fuels. So next come your second question. With reference to photic zone in an ocean, consider the following statement. So there is a zone called photic zone in oceans, and we have to consider the statements regarding it. The first statement is, in this region, photosynthesis by phytoplankton and plants take place. The second statement is, about 90% of all marine life lives in photic zone. So friends, if you know about the various zones in the ocean, like photic zone, aphotic zone, benthic zone, then you can easily answer this question. So the answer to this question is, options are A, B, C and D. So the C option is correct. Both 1 and 2 statements are correct. Basically friends, what is photic zone? Photic zone is that zone which receives the maximum amount of sunlight in the ocean. So if this is ocean, suppose this is the depth of the ocean, then till this depth, the sunlight will reach. For example, if here is 100% sunlight, then here it is 1% of this that is available at the surface. So that zone which receives the sunlight is called photic zone. So beneath it is the aphotic zone, which does not receive sunlight. So obviously friends, where the sunlight reaches, because energy, sunlight is the primary source of energy, which is converted into chemical energy by the process of photosynthesis. So it will be converted into chemical energy by the phytoplankton that is found in the in the oceans. So obviously in this region photosynthesis takes place by phytoplankton, and about 90% of the marine life lives here, because basically it is here that is the energy is easily available. So both the statements are correct. So basically about 90% of all marine life lives in photic zone, and it extends from the surface down to a depth where light intensity falls to 1% that at the surface, called the euphotic zone. So this zone, photic zone, is also sometimes called euphotic zone. But euphotic zone is that region in the ocean which receives maximum intensity of sunlight. So beneath it, the intensity goes on decreasing, and where it reaches 1% from 100%, then that complete zone is called photic zone. And beneath that photic zone is aphotic zone, where the light penetration is almost negligible. So here no photosynthesis takes place because sunlight does not reach it. So it is a kind of zone of consumption of oxygen. So respiration does take place here, but the photosynthesis does not take place. The organisms living here consume oxygen that is produced by the phytoplankton during the process of photosynthesis. So here there is no zone of photosynthesis, only the consumption of oxygen takes place. The third question is, what is the key difference between reserved forests and protected forests? So we have been given the statements. We have to consider these statements. First statement is, all activities are permitted unless restricted in protected forests, whereas in reserved forests all activities are restricted unless permitted. Second statement is, reserved forests are declared by union government, whereas protected forests are declared by the state government. Third statement is, reserved forests are owned by private individual, protected forests are not. So which of the following statements is correct? We have to analyze that. So friends, first statement is correct. The reserved forests, they are protected by the government, and all types of activities, whether grazing or other simple activities like cultivation, are prohibited in reserved forests unless it is permitted under certain conditions. So reserved forests enjoy the maximum degree of protection, whereas in the protected forests the activities are permitted unless they are restricted. So the first statement is correct. Regarding the second statement, friends, second statement is wrong. Why? Because both the reserved forests and protected forests can be declared by the state government. So it is not the case that reserved forests are declared by union government and protected forests are declared by state government. Both type of forests can be declared by state government. Next statement is, the reserved forests are owned by private individual and protected forests are not. Friends, this statement is also wrong. Both reserved and protected forests are government owned. Only the unclassed forests that do not come under the category of reserved or protected forests are owned by the private individuals, or they might also be owned by the government. But reserved forests and protected forests both are owned by the government. So which option is correct? The A only. One statement is correct. So A option is correct. So this is the justification that I have already explained to you. You can see it in detail while I will provide you MCQs. Next is, water absorption through roots can be increased by keeping the plants. So friends, you know that the roots absorb the water from the soil. So by doing what we can increase the water absorption capability of roots? Friends, the options are covered with the plastic bag. B is option in LED light. C option is under the fan. D is in dark shade. Friends, you might have heard about the transpiration process. So transpiration is what? Transpiration is basically a process wherein the water that is consumed by the roots of the plant, it leaves through the pores of the leaves. So plants have the leaves, so the water leaves the plant through these pores that are underneath the leaves. So if for example it is leaf, and this process is called transpiration. So how this will increase? By transpiration, it is the process that by transpiration the roots absorb the water from the soil. So transpiration is responsible for the water consumption. More the transpiration, more is the absorption. So friends, in these options only one option is correct, that is C, that is under the fan. So why it is correct? Because if you kind of place here a fan and you start it, then ultimately what will happen, the water released by the leaf, it will be kind of dispersed by the fan. So if it is not dispersed, for example, if there is here no fan here, then the water starts accumulating here. Then you know that the humidity capacity of a particular region is limited. So if there is already much humidity, then where will the rest of the moisture will go? It will face problem in leaving the plant, in leaving the leaf. So ultimately, if the plant water is not leaving the leaf, then the root will also not absorb the water. So if you kind of station here a fan, and it will disperse the moisture and it will increase the transpiration rate. So C option is correct. So this is what I have explained to you. So if in detail you want to see it, you can read from my PDF of these MCQs. Next is the state of world forests is published by. So friends, there is a report called State of Forest, which tell us the kind of condition of forest in the world, and at what level they are experiencing deforestation, and what is their condition. So it is this report is published by Food and Agriculture Organization. So it is a direct question. It is a kind of cramming question, so you have to remember it. The State of Forest report is published by Food and Agriculture Organization. The solution is B. So there is no explanation for this question. Next is the last question of the day. The Ganges shark is critically endangered because. First, friends, noted that there is a Ganges shark and it is critically endangered. It might all it can be it can also be asked in your prelims exam, that what is the conservation status of Gangetic shark. So friends, it is critically endangered. So here we have been asked the reason why it is critically endangered. First statement is they need to migrate to salt water to reproduce offsprings. Second is they are misinterpreted as large catfish and killed as they damage local ecosystem. So we have to see which of the following statements are correct. Friends, if you notice, though both the statements are wrong, because it is not the Ganges shark but the bull shark that has to migrate to salt water. Ganges shark has very very narrow zone of habitat, that is in the fresh water. So it does not need to migrate into salty water for reproduction. It is the bull shark that has to do this practice for reproduction. And the second statement is also wrong. Why it is wrong? Because the Gangetic shark, this Ganges shark, is confused with bull shark, and it is not confused with catfish, because catfish looks very different from the Ganges shark. So both the options are incorrect. So in the next slide we will see what are the reasons of it being critically endangered, but these both reasons are not correct. So none of these is correct. So option is D. D is the correct answer. So it is bull sharks that migrate to salt water, and not the Ganges shark. So it is found in very narrow range of habitat. So first statement is wrong. However, basically the construction of dams that we are doing and barrages that we are building, they kind of limiting the further the habitat of this Ganges shark, and they affect their migratory patterns and they threaten their life cycle. So it is one of the main reasons also for it becoming critically endangered. Construction of dams, barrages. And statement two, and it is also wrong because Ganges shark is confused with bull shark and not catfish. So, well, basically, what are the reasons for it being critically endangered? The overfishing, the habitat degradation from pollution, and increasing river use and management, for example, construction of dams and barrages, local killing for meat, gill net, and oil extra are the reasons for its population decline. So, friends, this is all about today's lecture. If you liked it, please like it. If you have any suggestion, please tell me in the comment box. I will certainly consider it. And if you want to stay tuned with us and want to be confident in your prelims exam, please subscribe to our channel. And friends, lastly, we have a Telegram channel also, the link of which I will provide in the description box. So in the description box of this video, the link of my Telegram channel is provided. So you can join that Telegram channel. What is the benefit of joining that Telegram channel? Actually, all the initiatives that we are running on different platforms, whether on YouTube or any other platform, we post it on that Telegram channel. So if you want to remain stay tuned with us, remain updated with us, you can join our Telegram channel. So how to join it, I will tell you in the next slide. So further, lastly, let me tell you, friends, if you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, you can WhatsApp us at this number 8968426481. So daily we are covering 5 questions. Until 31st May we will cover it. So approximately your 1100 to 1200 questions will be covered. So friends, for the purpose of our motivation as well as for the purpose of your affordability, we have kept just a minimal fees of rupees 50 for this entire course of MCQs of environment and ecology. It means you have to make a single time payment of rupees 50 and you will be subscribing to our PDF till 31st May. That means you will get 1100 to 1200 questions in just rupees 50. So friends, why it is important? Now question comes, why it is important to join to subscribe to PDFs if the videos are available? Friends, at the end of the day, when you're at the last minute of your exam, when your exam is near, you will have to revise quickly the whole syllabus. So it is not the only the environment and ecology that you will have to revise. The other topics will also be there, like history, polity, geography, economy, art and culture, current affairs and all other science and tech. So in that case, you can't see 20 to 25 minute long video for the revision purpose, because at that time you must have some kind of handy notes to revise quickly your basic concepts and you must, so that you can be confident while attempting your exam, so that you can be very much confident that you have revised the entire syllabus. So if you want these last minute kind of PDFs for the purpose of revision, you can WhatsApp us at this number 8968426481. And lastly friends, how to join our Telegram channel? Friends, there is an app called eSandesh that is available on App Store as well as on Google Play Store. So you have to download it, and in the search box here you will see, here is a search box, you can copy the link of my Telegram channel which I have provided in description box, and you can paste it here. So by doing this you will get to my channel. So when you will get to my channel, you can join it. So this is the way to join our Telegram channel. So this is the app for that Telegram channel. Thank you friends, thank you very much. This is all about